Hey there, friends. I hope you're having a great Tuesday. I have three journals to go into the shop today. These are the starter journals. They are 6 1/4 by, I always forget that. I think it's 5 1/2. Hang on. Caller hold, please. Hold on. Oh, no, that's the fairy book, so that's really small, which I just want to tell you guys, I will be making more fairy books. I kind of thought, no, you know, at the end of, like, the applique thing, I thought, okay, well, it's the end of the applique thing, so I will probably not make any more of these books. However, you guys know that I'm de-stashing, so I found a couple of these really pretty little appliques, so I will be using more of that kind of thing on these journals, as well as some architectures pieces. Those are the pieces from Canvas Core brand that I really do like. I'm sorry, we got off track. 6 1/4 by 4 1/2, and it's 1.5 on the spine, so you've got 1.5 inches of spine with these. I really like this size. They're fun to work with. They're a petite version of a flow journal, and you guys seem to really, really like them, and I want you guys to know how I take my cues from you. I really do watch my sales, and I love it when you guys let me know that you like a certain size, or you like a certain style, or you like a certain look. I really appreciate knowing that, and thank all of you for supporting the Etsy shop. I really do appreciate that as well. We have a little Tinkerbell starter journal. I was into the color green. As we recall, I had a little phase with purple last week. I think we have a couple of those purple journals still left in the store. If you guys are looking for a small gift for someone, I think that these would be super cool. Of course, I did make my 10-step series in how to use a flow journal. I'll put an iCard up here. I've created a playlist for my how to use a flow journal, which is a free class on YouTube. Let's look at the spine of this baby. I added these sweet, these are glass leaves, and I did this on each of them. The spines are the exact same. Glass beads, a couple of plastic beads, Czechoslovakian beads, and these glass leaves that I thought just looked really sweet on these. So let's take a look. I am really into stamping right now, so I am using a lot of stamped images. Of course, our magazine pages are just full of inspiration and color blocks. So do look for your color blocks and your images. That is lesson one of how to use a flow journal, is harvesting this part of your journal. I love this typewriter. This typewriter is a receptacle for pens, so it's like a pen holder. I thought that was super neat. More small images. If you guys are doing the art trading coins, you might want to check out smaller images to put on your art trading coins. Got a fabric swatch for you guys. This is some inky paper, some Monopoly money. I am also into cursive writing. As you guys know, we use a lot of salvage script in these books, in the bigger flow journals. In the bigger flow journals, you will find just more stuff, and you'll find a lot more vintage stuff as well. But I've been working on my handwriting, so I thought I would stick a few handwriting pieces in here for you guys. Dream big or dream small. It's the small things that really make up a life, isn't it? These are pages from the art history book that is annotated. I love these things. The Hallmark mushroom playing card, famous people from the Old West. I like to get you using your head. Famous people from the Old West. I like Gunsmoke. Now I know these weren't real people. Maybe Annie Oakley. Annie Oakley is my favorite Western heroine. We've got some recipes for you. I love the illustrations. We've talked about that before. A vintage birth notice that's cute because it's got the dad in here and he's scrubbing diapers and he's strung them on the line. When my son is almost 40, one of my sons is 40, almost 40. The other is 33, almost 33. But when my 40-year-old son was little, I did the line drawing with his diapers. Of course, by the time the second one rolled around, we were using Pampers I was using Pampers because I had to go back to work quite quickly after that one. I've got some bling in here for you, some Pictionary pages. This again is one of those, this is the paper bag paper that has a little bit of tissue paper on it. So we've got a lot of vintage book pages for you to work with, vintage dictionary pages, more playing cards. I should have put a book in here for you guys. Hang on just a second. I made books last night. So let's get a book in here for you folks. There we go. You've got a mini book to play with, a napkin to play with. This is a paper bag. There's fabric in here. The paper bag full of items for you to use as you make ATCs or art trading coins or mini mixed medias or whatever your little heart desires out of these flow journals. As I reminded you a while ago, the spines are all the same here. So we've got glass beads, Czechoslovakian beads. We've got some plastic beads as well. We start out with a wild and free reminder. We've got a mini book right here for you. The stamping, I think I'm getting the hang of it, you guys. I think I'm getting the hang of stamping. Got some pretty magazine pages right here for you. This one says Garden of Eden. I think that is really gorgeous. I think these were from a home decor magazine. It's fun to think about, you know, how you would decorate your, like, perfect home or your tiny home or even your RV. That's kind of my dream, is to have a home on wheels. I think that's kind of intriguing to me. The number six, some stickers in this pocket of fabric swatch right here. More of the stamped image paper. And of course, anything that looks like this, you guys can take out of here and make into a card. These books are just packed with card making material. The word glow, I think that's a good word, don't you? Unless you get sunburned and then you don't want to glow. Some bling and tags and bookmarks for you to play with. More of the I love those vintage Hallmark cards. That was a good score at the Paul's Abilities thrift store there in Fort Mill, South Carolina. A little bit of texture for you guys to play with. The letter W, never know what might start with that. Maybe welcome, maybe wonderful, maybe what else would start with W? Well, starts with W. We've got our recipe cards in here with a vintage Christmas card that says Your Geranium Helper Millie. So it's signed by Millie. I don't know what a geranium helper is. A little bit of feather imagery for you. This is a sticker sheet and a chipboard piece. A piece that says Inspire. Love the colors on those. A tag and a napkin right here. One of my styrofoam carved feathers. That's always fun to do. It's hard though when I empty out a styrofoam carton. I'm always thinking, I would like to keep that. That would be super cool. So I keep the top of it, but I do recycle the bottom of it. But then you get like a whole lot of styrofoam. Styrofoam's good for a lot of things. Sorry, the neighbors are away and their truck alarm goes off like every 40 minutes. I don't know how to get in touch with them. They've been gone for like a week and their truck alarm has gone off for a week every 40 minutes. This is our last little journal. It says, go your own way. Stamped images, a mini book for you guys. I sat and made mini books last night. Making mini books is a great meditation. This has some inky papers in it, as well as the images from a Victorian magazine. I am going to order myself this magazine. It has such beautiful images in it. I actually have one of these. Chris bought me like this little tea light butter dish thing. Several years ago when we were on a trip somewhere. And it's very soothing. I like it. More images for you to play with. I really do like my candelabra stamp. I think that's very kind of steampunk. The art insert in this book talks about the color wheel, uses of color and shadow. Beautiful images. Again, you know, it's highlighted. I can just see someone studying so hard to understand art. This is more of my handwriting. It says shine. And some tea dyed tags up here for you. I also took some of these cards and just randomly put words on it. And then this little ticket says a little thing called love. Fabric swatches, and we've got some bling and playing cards for you guys. This is our vintage recipe element. So we've got a beautiful vintage card signed. It's not signed, but it does have Minnie and Miriam Dalton on it. I really like this stamp. She's very pensive and beautiful. She's definitely not a whippersnapper. Oh man, I love these vintage pages. The other day it was super, super hot. And I came up here, I had been working on these inserts. And I walked upstairs and it smelled like a library. I was like, oh my gosh, it smells so good in here. I have a new library and it is beautiful. It's built kind of into the trees. So there are places to sit and read and study where it's almost like you're in a treehouse because it's glass. Oh, it's just so beautiful. I miss that smell though. I think if anybody could like put that smell into like a scented candle maybe. Y'all work on that. Library smell, scented candle. I think that a lot of us would buy that smell. Okay, you guys. So these three journals are going in the shop today. We are kind of in a green phase. I am I'm starting a few new journals today, and I don't know where that color thing is going to take me, but it always takes me somewhere. It's always an adventure to put these together for you guys. I'm so glad that you're enjoying them. You guys have a marvelous day and make you some magic. Talk to you soon, y'all. Bye.